And I'd like to take this moment to introduce to you our speaker for today, who will be speaking about the current state of professionalization of midwifery in Europe. Yuri Vermeulen is the head of midwifery at Erasmus Brussels University of Applied Science and Arts in Belgium. He's a researcher at VUB in Brussels, Belgium. He's also an executive board member of the European Midwives Association and the Belgian Midwives Association. So, midwifery education and professionalization of the profession are his main areas of interest. And welcome. So good to see you, Yuri. And I'd just like to go ahead and make you presenter, and you can present away.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Suzanne. Thank you, Linda. Thank you for facilitating my session. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I am very glad that you all are here. And first of all, I would like to give you my best wishes for this International Day of the Midwife. And I hope you will enjoy this collaborative learning today here at VIDM. So enjoy your day. I also would like to acknowledge my co-researchers, which are Hans Leuben, Valerie Fleming, Rona O'Connell, Patricia Gillen, and Ramon Esquivel. So today I would like to talk to you and to share my ideas about the professionalization of midwifery, especially focused on Europe. First of all, it is very important to know that midwifery is regulated in Europe by the European Directive. The European Directive is a kind of legislation for the whole of Europe, which determines the minimum training requirements for midwives, the minimum educational program for midwives, and the professional activities of a midwife for the whole of Europe. That's one fact. A second fact is that we had in Europe the Declaration of Bologna. It's already about 20 years ago. The Bologna Declaration was a kind of a legislation reforming higher education into the level of bachelor education, master education, or PhD education. I will come back to that later on. And a third fact is that midwifery is trying to professionalize over the last decades. The aim of our study was to explore the state of professionalization of midwifery all over Europe. And we would like to focus on the education of midwives, research, and practice of midwives in Europe. To structure our study, we used a very old criteria for a profession, the criteria of Greenwood. I will not go into much detail, but Greenwood said that you have a high level of professionalization when a profession has an own body of knowledge, if they are recognized, their authority is recognized by its clientele, if they have a code of ethics, and if they have a professional organization. We did two studies. First of all, we invited delegates from Europe, delegates who are delegates from a country in the European Midwives Association, to complete a questionnaire. And in a second phase, we did an analysis of six countries. I will move to both phases. In the first phase, we had responses from the whole of Europe. We invited 30 European countries. So European countries, that means not only countries from the European Union, but also countries like European EU applicant countries. So we had responses from 29 countries covering like Iceland, Scandinavia, the Baltics, Romania, Bulgaria, until Turkey. So we really had whole of Europe, which was excellent. So we asked, what is the state of professionalization of midwifery in your country? And if we are going to the findings from this phase, then I think that we can conclude that midwifery education and midwifery practice evolved a lot over the last 20 years. Nearly all midwifery educations in Europe went to a bachelor or a master level. But on the other hand, we need also to acknowledge that a lot of midwives struggle in practice. And I mean by struggling in practice, in a lot of countries, midwives are working in an obstetric-led system of care, where her autonomy or independence is limited. Another striking result, yeah, we know it, but okay, now we have concluded it. We know that maternity care is not an exclusive domain for midwives only, but you also have doctors, obstetricians, nurses, other health professionals, which makes it difficult for midwives to fight, struggle for their autonomy. And it also means that midwives not always have the responsibility for regulating their own profession. And we are midwives. We are there to do our midwifery work. We are there to be midwife. That's all correct. But we can see that in a lot of countries, the involvement of midwives, in health policy is quite limited. And that's an issue we should work on, I guess, in future, but I will come to that later. So the organization of healthcare in a country is determining midwifery work. Eh? If you have a country where maternity care is obstetric led, or a country where it is more midwifery-led, it has a huge impact on practice. The involvement of the other health professionals. So we saw on a global European level that there are some matters of concern anyhow. The study of the phase one, we published this study in the European Journal of Midwifery. You can find the study easily on via the website of the European Journal of Midwifery. I would also like to take the opportunity to highlight the fact that the European Journal of Midwifery is a free, open access website where you can consult all full text articles for free. So In a next phase, we did some descriptive case studies from six countries to focus on the professionalization in some countries. We selected Bulgaria, Ireland, Germany, Norway, Luxembourg, and Spain due to the variation in education, autonomy, practice, and research. I would like to emphasize that we have got the information from those countries, from key figures in maternity care from those countries. But I would like to emphasize that I don't make any judgment about a country or about their maternity care. It's not up to me. It's only, I only would like to highlight the differences in the different countries. And it's not about right, it's not about wrong. It's sometimes about limitations that midwives have to work in accordance to the European directive. Like if we have a look to the midwifery education, yeah, you can see that in some countries midwifery education is on a bachelor level. In some countries it is on a master level. But we also have a country where today midwifery education is still on a diploma level. A diploma level, I mean by that, it is like a kind of a secondary education level. It is not a bachelor level. And we can also see like in Germany only recently made the move to a bachelor midwifery education. So we can see a lot of variety in those education. You can also see that in some countries midwifery education is direct entry, and in some countries it is directly after it is after a nursing education. If you have a look at research or PhD in midwifery, in some countries it is obvious midwives, they can do research, midwives, they can go for the PhD, but still in some countries midwives cannot do research. It is not acknowledged. It is strange if midwives are doing research. She's not a doctor. Why is she doing research? It's strange in some countries. And in some countries, it is difficult, even impossible, to get a PhD as a midwife. If we will have a look at community sanctions, or if the authority of a midwife recognized by its clientele, by the women, then you can see that in some countries midwives are responsible. They can work independently. They are the specialist in the low risk pregnancy, childbirth. But as I said, in some countries, midwives work in the hospital under the supervision of an obstetrician in a midwifery led, in an obstetrician led led care. Also, it is a case that in some countries, the manager of the maternity care is not a midwife, but is either a doctor or a nurse. Let's move into the autonomy. Autonomy, in this study, we understood autonomy as independency. We are working separate from nurses. Autonomy in some countries, and that's already determined, in some countries midwives are not at all the first point of care for women. In some countries it is just the doctor. And that is often when we are in a obstetrician-led system. Also, as I said before, autonomy in a hospital setting is really limited in a lot of countries. If you think that autonomy is very important for you as a midwife, then often it is better to go to work like in as an independent midwife or in a birth center, all that kind of things, because we saw in Europe a huge difference between autonomy in independent care and autonomy in the nurses in the hospitals. So it's a really huge difference. We also see in some countries that there is an increase in specialist roles for some midwives. Like in some countries, you have specialist roles for lactation midwives, bereavement midwives, all that kind of midwives. And if we will have a look at the community sanctions, then first of all, it is important to acknowledge that all midwifery, all countries in Europe, they have a midwifery association. Sometimes they have a midwifery association which is independent. Sometimes they have a midwifery association together with nurses. In one country, there is also an association altogether with doctors. But all countries have a midwifery association, so that is fine. But in some countries, you have several midwifery associations, and you could say, oh, that's fine. The more, the better. But this is a personal thought. I don't agree with that I think that if you have several midwifery associations in one country, then you will have different voices. You will not have one strong, powerful midwifery voice from that country. And I think that that can be misused by policymakers. Because if I am a policymaker and I have to think and discuss about maternity healthcare of the future, and I am going to talk with the midwifery association in my country, the independent midwives, the hospital midwives, the midwifery educators, the Catholic midwives, the French-speaking midwives, the Dutch-speaking midwives, then as a policymaker, I will get a lot of information. I will get a lot of contradictory information. And as a politician, I will take what I want to take. I will take whatever I like. I will not be, as a politician, confronted with one midwifery voice. So I think that is something to think about, that is something to reflect. But this is only a personal thought. The issue is we have midwifery associations. Okay, that's great. But the issue is, do we have influence on politics, on legislation? And you can see, like my colleagues from Bulgaria, Luxembourg, Spain, they said to me, no, we have no influence as an association at all. That can have different causes, but very often it is politicians, they are not interested in us, they don't listen to us, we are with not enough midwives, they will listen to the doctors, and go so on. Yeah? So the fact is that not in all countries midwives have influence. I think that could be because there is no formal place for a midwifery officer in government or in advisory committees. If I may say something, this needs to change. If I ask my colleagues from the different countries, what changed in your country over the last 10 years, then you can see it, eh? Legislation, regulation, legislation, education, recognition, education, legislation, legislation, education, financial situation, that's also about legislation, education. I think we should focus on this one. These countries, they made huge changes over the last years. And the trigger for the change was always, if I may say it, legislation, regulation, education. I think that we should keep in mind, if you want to make changes, those are the triggers which can help us. If we asked our colleagues about what is difficult or how do you see the future, or what are challenges for the futures, then we see again it's about law, directive, education, strategy, which is also kind of legislation, education. Competences are underused. I think we know about that in a lot of countries. Profession, education, perception, strategy. So it is all about, again, education, legislation, and regulation, I think. On the other hand, I wanted to make a side note, because I am talking about education, legislation, regulation. Yeah, okay, that's good. But that's also a personal thought. I think you should need to keep in mind that it is difficult to make changes to your profession or to your professionalization if you are not supported by the public. I mean, and I don't know, and we can have a discussion later on. I think that in a lot of countries, midwifery associations are not linking very good or very structured with women's groups. And I think that's an important one, because we really need to know what do women want, and so that we are partners together. Because if I am talking to politicians about, more midwifery is so important and we need more autonomy, and because we are so important, okay, I totally agree that we are so important, but the politician in the next half hour, he will hear the doctors talking how important they are. They are important. He will hear about the nurses, he will hear about the dentists, the pharmacists, and every professional group who respects itself. They say, I am important, what I am doing is an important job. Yeah, and so for midwifery, I totally agree. We should evolve to more midwifery-led care, but we need to do it hand in hand with the women, with the public. If we can have some overview about the conclusions of the two phases of our study, then I think we can say that the move to higher education is an important trigger for the professionalization of midwifery. So I think that if midwifery education is still on a secondary level, that is quite concerning. But okay, it is what it is. But I think that's an important evolution, that we have the education at least on a bachelor level. You can discuss about it. So, but I think that's a move we need to go anyhow, if we are looking to the European Directive and the Bologna Declaration. So that's a move we need to go in Europe. For the moment, it's only like one country who is struggling with that move, and it is not because of the midwives. Again, it's about politics. We can see an increase in midwifery research. We can see more and more midwives with a PhD. We have in some countries midwifery professors. And like in my country, we at this moment, it's a quite new recent move, but we have to my knowledge like only 3 professors in midwifery at the moment, which is a good evolution. So it's going slowly, but it's going, it's an evolution. You know, you can feel I am positive. Eh? If you have a look at the changes in midwifery practice, we had some people from countries who were very positive. They said, yes, okay, we have specialist roles, we can work, like we are not working only in labor rooms, but we can only also work like in fertility clinic, in the gynecology, in the neonatal work. But on the other hand, I have to say to you that we see also some negative responses from people, from midwives who said, no, there was no evolution. Even my scope of practice is limited, and there is there is more and more medicalization of birth. And we all know if you have an increase in the medicalization, then you will have a decrease in the professionalization of the midwifery. You will have a decrease in the autonomy of the midwives. So that is a very difficult balance we should think about, because we see indeed, if you are looking like to the Eurostat figures, we can see an increase in medicalization. So the Bologna Declaration, the European Directive, was very important in the professionalization for midwifery, and I really mean it. The European Directive is a legislation, and the legislation is talking about the 7 privileged professions. Privileged professions are professions who are privileged because they have an own chapter in the European Directive, because they are so important for the public health. I think we need to keep that European Directive. We need to keep the European Directive, and we as midwives, we need to kept in the European Directive, because I say to you, and I am very clear about it, if the midwife would not be a separated chapter in this directive, then I am sure that midwifery in some countries, and I will not name the countries, will disappear in some years. So the European Directive is a very important one. I also wanted to say to you, and I've said it already, that our professionalization is limited by the organization of healthcare and by the involvement of other healthcare professionals in the maternity care. As a conclusion, I would like to say that, as I emphasized, that legislation, regulation are very important tools for the professionalization of midwifery, for the empowerment of the professionalization. I think that you also need to keep in mind that it is very important to build on very good, useful networks. If you want to midwifery to professionalize, you should not focus only on midwifery, but you need to look for partners in crime, like other health professionals and like policy makers, because we as midwives, and that is a very important task for midwifery associations, we need to be on the table where the policy making is discussed. We need to be there. We need to be invited, or we need to invite ourselves. And the last thing I wanted to say, that is, we need a united midwifery community, at least in your own country. I see a lot of examples of countries where midwives are, midwifery associations or midwives are opposing to each other, where they are not unified. And I think that is very bad for midwifery, because if you are not talking with one strong midwifery voice, then your voice will not be heard. That is my conclusion for today. I wish you once again a very nice International Day of the Midwife, and please take today and this VIDM education, take this as a moment to reflect on where we want to go in the future. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Yuri, for that very insightful and inspiring conversation. Thank you for walking us through the history of professionalization of midwifery in Europe, and for your key focus areas where you've said that we have made progress in the last few years in terms of legislation, regulation, and education, but we still need to do a lot more in terms of partnership, a lot more in terms of policy making, having a seat in policy making. And I think one of the other things you really highlighted is public support, where women's groups are key to actually letting the legislators themselves know exactly what kind of support women need. And there's a lot of consensus in the chat. So Rona says that the EU directive is very important for advancing midwives, and education is also key to effect change. Then Cleo says that fortunately we have autonomy in practicing as freelancers here in Greece. Kaveri says midwives to become political is such an important message, one that I have been hearing from around the world. And then Cleo also says thank you. And H. Gomar at Yahoo, you say you had a couple of things to say. So they said it's a very inspiring presentation, a call for unity, and a need for more collaboration. So I'll just let us take just one quick question, Yuri, and that came up earlier when you talked about autonomy. There was a question of why are nurses involved in the prenatal care? Shouldn't that be the work of a midwife? So that was a question that had come earlier as you were speaking about autonomy. So perhaps you could respond to that, and then we can close this very insightful session.
Yeah. So the question is about autonomy in antenatal care or in postnatal care?
So you had your slide, it was in postnatal care.
Okay, I see it. It's a question from Linda. Yeah, Linda, I totally agree. I totally agree. Why are nurses involved in postnatal care? Should that not be a midwife? Yeah, I think it should be a midwife. And it is also stated in the European directive that midwives should have access to postnatal care. Maybe for some people here around, it sounds stupid and strange. It is normal that a midwife is involved in postnatal care. Yeah, maybe you think that is normal, and I thought also that is normal. But when we asked the European countries, then we saw that in some countries midwives are not allowed to perform postnatal care. It is nurses. Why is it like that? I don't know why it is like that, but it is like that. Very often it is from history. It has always been like that. It is the organization of the healthcare. And it is like, it is just like that. Like, for instance, I don't know if we have people from Slovenia around. But for instance, we know that in Slovenia, midwives have a lot of difficulties to work in the postnatal care. It's because that has something to do with the organization of healthcare. We also have another example, like from Finland. In Finland, you see that antenatal care is performed by nurses and not by midwives. So that's also quite strange in our thinking. It is not very compliant with the European directive, but yeah, it's the way it is. And very often midwife associations from those countries, they are struggling to change that. They are always with a paper from the European directive. It is mentioned in the directive that I am allowed to do postnatal care. But once again, it is about legislation, political influence, history. It has always been like that. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much, Yuri. And I think it provides an opportunity, if nothing else, now that we have had people attend this session, they can begin to think about how they can pull together and bring about the change that they want to see. It'll definitely take some time. It'll definitely take some concerted collaboration, as we'd had earlier from the chat, but I think it can be done.